Welcome to Craftastrophe. So today we're going to make some balloon Easter eggs. So what we need for this is a plate and a balloon and some candy. So we're gonna use some different candies. I have some little egg candies of different flavors, and then I have these little candy things. So first what we do is we're gonna stick these candies in here. So you pick which candies you want and how many you want. And then we're gonna stick them in the balloon here. That will be the challenging part. Let's see if we can get these little things in the little balloon here. So you wanna like finagle it around a little bit, but you don't wanna rip it. You wanna get the little eggs in there. Just like that, trying to stretch it in there. It's a little on the difficult side, but we'll get in there eventually. There we go, there's one. Okay, so now we're gonna stick a second one in there. And just to have extra, we're gonna do a third one in there. Okay, so we got three eggs in our balloon now. So now we're gonna blow up the balloon. However you want it, however big you want it to be, you can let out some air. So I'm gonna make a little miniature one. Tie the balloon here. So in this balloon, we have candy. So this is a fun craft to make. It's a little on the messy side, so we're actually gonna need some newspaper. So once you have your balloon to the size that you want it, you're going to put the balloon over here. And what you'll wanna do is make a mixture of tacky glue. I've tried this before and the regular glue didn't work too well. So we're gonna give a try with the tacky glue. And then you put water in there, and it says to do like half a cup of water, but I only did like a third of a cup of water in there because I wanted to make it a little bit thicker so that the glue will actually stick to the balloon. So we have the balloon, we have the glue, and then we have yarn or crochet. I will cut this into pieces just to whatever size you want it to be. So I'm doing about 2 feet. So you cut a whole bunch of these. Once you have those cut, what we're gonna do is we're gonna glue these pieces to the balloon. So first what we'll do, after you have your mixture and you have it all mixed up, you take out the fork. And I would also suggest using plastic or throwaway type bowls or plates. That way you don't have to worry about cleaning them or about glue drying in there. The glue is washable, so that's not a problem whatsoever. So here we go, we're gonna dump this in here. We soak it in the glue. Your fingers are gonna get all messy too. So we have it soaked in the glue, and it does like to knot up. Just gently go like that. Pull it out. What we're gonna do is wrap it around the balloon. So you find your starting part where at a point where you wanna start it, and you just wrap it around. Okay, so there's our first one right there. And so we're gonna do this over and over again until we have it completely full. We have some more rope here, and I would actually suggest that you pre-cut it and then just kinda lay each one out, and then you can grab one at each time that you're ready to grab it. Play with it and figure out what works best for you. So we got this piece all soaked. So we're gonna do this again. Make sure the top part is soaked also, the part where you're holding it. And like I said, it's a very messy craft. So we're just gonna go like this. Just keep wrapping it around. And don't worry about the glue and the coloring on your yarn or whatever you're using. The color will come back and the glue dries clear. So like I said, we just do this multiple times until you get it to the point where most of the balloon is covered. So put this back on just like the other ones. And I would actually suggest that you start from the top so that you have kind of a beginning piece here. So we're gonna go like this. Just keep wrapping it around till it covers. It doesn't matter if it's looped or over or whatever, but you're just gonna keep doing this until you end. Okay, so I'm down to the last few that need to be put on here. So basically what we're gonna do, so we've been wrapping these around and sticking them on there. So we have a couple more to stick on there. And then once those are done, we're gonna smooth out what we have, and then we'll have to wait until it's dry. And then when it's dry, we get to do the next step. So I've been going like this and pulling out some of the excess glue because you don't need all that glue on there. You just need enough to make it so it sticks. Just make sure the top part is has glue on it so it sticks also. So what I've been trying to do is cover up the spots where there's the one sticking out, so that way it'll cover better. Just grab those, and I've been tucking them in also in some of the spots just to make sure that it stays in, and then just keep watching and looking for spots that have little open spaces, which some open spaces are okay because you're gonna want to be able to see through this once it's done. So we have a couple more to stick on here just to make sure that it's nicely covered. And earlier I did have to add more glue and water to it because I almost ran out. So just keep in mind that you might have to use a little extra. It does get a little slippery, so it's a little hard to hold, but it all works out. Okay, so here we have our balloon, and now we just have to wait for it to dry, which it takes a little bit for it to dry. And then we'll go on to the next step once this is dry and show you how to finish it off. And then eventually we're gonna pop the balloon, and then we pull out the excess pieces that are in there of it. And then later on, you can eat your candy that's in there. Okay, so one last thing that we actually have to do before we let it dry is we have to put more glue on top of it so that the glue will make it settle better. So I'm gonna use this little paintbrush and I'm gonna paint some glue on here. Just use a whole bunch. Just vigorously put a ton of paint or glue on here. Splotch it in there. That way I make sure that it all stays together. Don't forget the bottom part. And while it's drying, the glue will actually fall off and like go onto the plate. And like I said, it's probably best to use disposable things, and then that way you don't have to worry about cleaning up afterwards. You can just throw it away and get rid of whatever you used for putting all this together. Okay, so it looks like we got this all glued up here. So we're just waiting for it to dry now. And once it's dry, we're go on to the next thing. Okay, so we waited a day for this to dry, and it's dry for the most part, but it's still a little soft. So this time I'm going to add some spray on adhesive. So you shake it up like that, and you do actually want to read the instructions first to make sure that you know what you're doing. So what we're going to do is we're going to spray it onto here. So open it up, we go like this. Pick up our project and then we spray it on just all the way around. We just let it sit for a few minutes after we're done spraying it. Don't forget the bottom part too. Okay, so it's all sprayed. So now we're gonna let it sit for a few minutes. And then after that few minutes is over, we're gonna do the final step here, which is popping the balloon. Okay, so this adhesive stuff dried really fast. So what I'm going to do now is pop the balloon, and once the balloon is popped, you'll be able to see the candy inside of this here. So what I would do is I would use some tape, and then I would tape it on here, and then when you use the tape, I've heard that it's supposed to make it so that you don't hear the pop sound when a balloon pops. Another suggestion would also be to put the tape on in the balloon before you put the yarn on. And then that way you have a solid spot where you know that you can pop it and it won't make that big pop sound. Especially for kids, if they're doing this, they might get scared of the little pop sound. So here we go, and we're gonna give it a try to pop that balloon. I'm gonna take our piece of tape here and stick it in between some of the yarn here. And go like that. Take the balloon off of here. And okay, so we have our little spot here that we're gonna pop the balloon with. Just gonna make sure it's on there solid. And let's hope that we don't get a large pop. So now it looks like the air's just gonna come out nice and slowly. Okay, so we have this hole and it's going to deflate on us now. And once it deflates, we're gonna have a solid balloon here. You can hear it coming off. Nice and slowly. Okay, so the Easter egg came out like this, And somehow within the balloon, since the balloon didn't pop all the way, the candy is stuck in the balloon. But so here's the Easter egg. It looks like it does need to dry a little bit more on the bottom part there. So anyway, here's the egg after the balloon is popped, and so it still relatively looks like an egg. And so you can also use it as decoration, or you can use it for like outside party, you know, like a light candle type thing. You probably even stick a candle in there. That'd be pretty cool. Or one of those flameless ones, and just battery operated, and you can do it outdoors too. Okay, so the last thing that we're gonna do with this is we have to pull out the balloon here. So what I'm gonna do is gonna grab a little bit of the balloon, and then I'm gonna use some small craft scissors and cut open the balloon like that. And then we're gonna use the tweezers here to get some of this balloon out. Oh, look at that. Got some balloon here. So I'm gonna cut this part of the balloon off. Grab another part of it, cut some more of it off. Getting there. Oh, there we go. There's the candy. Candy came out. Okay, so now just gotta grab the balloon here. Okay, now we got the balloon. Woohoo! Balloon came out. Okay, so now we have candy in there. And I would suggest probably putting more candy in there. There's only three little pieces, but it's kind of cool. So anyway, so I'm gonna hang this up until the bottom part dries completely. And once that's completely dry, you have your completed balloon with candy in it. And then you can give it to your friends, coworkers, kids, you know, whoever, and it can be a fun little Easter present. So there you go. And one more option that you can do, you can cut out a little, like a little hole, and make it look like a little hut. And then you can put little green grass pieces in there, and then and you can put candy, just, you know, put candy or eggs in there and all that sort of stuff. So anyway, that is how to make a balloon candy Easter present type thing. So thank you for watching, and please watch my other videos, and see you next time. Hello, and thank you for watching today's episode of Craftastrophe. So, I hope you enjoyed learning how to make a yarn balloon basket egg thingy bobber. And just a side note, it did take a little extra time for the glue to dry. And it actually took a whole extra day. And so, if your balloon does come out with some glue that's still wet, don't worry about it, and you can just reshape the balloon, and then I would put some string on top of it and then hang it up somewhere so it can dry so that it doesn't get all smushed up. So that's my only side note for that one. So anyway, check out my last video, and check out our other channels, and hit the subscribe button, and you can also follow us on any of our social networks that we're on too. So thanks for watching, and hope to see you next time.